Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to this Faculty of Business and Economics graduation ceremony for the University of Auckland. Our official proceedings will begin shortly. In a moment, your graduands will enter the auditorium and you'll be invited to stand. They will then be followed by the academics and our official party. As the official party enters, we invite you to join the singing of the traditional graduation song, Gaudiamus. Please take your seat as the Chancellor takes his seat. If you're carrying a cell phone, please ensure it's either turned off or made silent. And whilst you're very welcome to take photographs, please move back to your seat once you've done that. And please don't stand in the aisles. At the end of the ceremony, the Chancellor will invite the gathering to sing God Defend New Zealand for the first time with your new graduates. Please then remain standing following the end of the anthem as the processions leave the auditorium. Once the last graduates have left, you will also be invited to leave. Ladies and gentlemen, please stand.
kua eke mai nei ki te tau toko I te kaupapa nei e. Ara mai rā, nau mai rā, piki mai rā, kia kautau ngā tau I ra kua eke rā ki te rā tau mata. Mai te pare wānanga o tā maki makaurau, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou.
Please be seated. Enga mana, enga reo, enga hawe wha, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou katoa. Vice-Chancellor, Pro-Chancellor, Council members, special guests, staff, graduands, family and friends of graduands. As Chancellor of the University of Auckland, I extend a warm welcome to you all on behalf of Council members and staff of the university. I welcome our guest speaker, Ms. Catherine Courage. I also acknowledge the recent passing of Dr. Mere Mere Penfold, who was a long-term member of the University of Auckland staff, a distinguished Māori scholar, and for many years the kuia at our graduation ceremonies. This is a meeting of the Council of the University of Auckland for the purpose of conferring degrees and awarding diplomas. This week, we will be conferring and awarding more than 6,572 qualifications on some 6,478 students in person and in absentia. At this ceremony, 464 students will graduate in person and 171 students will graduate in absentia. I will be assisted by Mr. Peter Kiley, Pro-Chancellor. This is a happy and memorable occasion for you, the graduands, as well as your families and friends who have supported you during your studies. We congratulate you all. Equally, your achievement brings pleasure and satisfaction to the academic and professional staff of the university who have played their part in your success. Capping is a time for celebration. The graduation procession today brought academic flavour and colour to the streets of Auckland, and in this ceremony, you'll experience the pomp and tradition befitting your well-deserved day of celebration. Over a period of 130 years, the University of Auckland has become a comprehensive, research-led university with a strong international reputation. Today, there are more than 40,000 students and 5,000 staff. Moreover, we are New Zealand's largest research organisation, with one third of the country's externally rated world-class researchers. Within New Zealand, only our university is ranked within the top 1% of the world's universities. We also have a strong commitment to Māori education. Of all the Māori degree graduates in New Zealand each year, 25% come from just one institution, the University of Auckland. The quality and international reputation of a university are fundamentally driven by the achievements of its people, and last year was an exceptional one for our academic staff, who won almost every form of recognition available to them in New Zealand. In July, Professor Alison Jones and Associate Professors Bryony James and Katha Simpson won National Tertiary Teaching Excellence Awards for sustained excellence in tertiary teaching. These awards mean that for 11 of the last 12 years, our teachers have been recognised as among the very best in the country. In November, engineers, distinguished emeritus Professor John Boyes and Professor Grant Kovic won the Supreme Award at the Prime Minister's Science Prize Awards for their work in inductive power transport. Dr. Ben O'Brien from the Auckland Bioengineering Institute won the McDiarmid Emerging Scientist Prize for his groundbreaking work on artificial muscles. And Dr. Susie Wiles from Molecular Medicine and Pathology won the Science Media Communication Prize. Our staff also excelled at the 2013 Royal Society of New Zealand Awards, winning 4 major medals. The most notable was Distinguished Professor Dame Anne Salmon from Māori Studies, winning the Society's highest honour, the Rutherford Medal. This was awarded for her eminent work on Māori social structures and interactions within the European world and on European exploration in the Pacific. She was also named Kiwi Bank New Zealand of the Year for 2013. These achievements reflect the outstanding quality, not only of our academic staff, but also of the students who work with them and the many professional staff who support them. A key part of our challenge for the future, and one that is clearly reflected in our strategic plan, is to continue to invest in a community of highly accomplished staff and students. An important element of that investment is ensuring that our teaching facilities are of the highest quality. To this end, the Council completed in 2013 the purchase of the former Lion Brewery site in Newmarket as the basis for a new campus which will be integrated with the existing City and Grafton campuses. At Newmarket, work is well underway on construction of the engineering research laboratories. These buildings represent an investment of approximately $88 million to support our engineering research and postgraduate teaching for the benefit of all New Zealand. We will occupy the first of these new facilities in July this year. Work has also begun on the new science tower on the corner of Wellesley and Simon Streets. This major construction project represents an investment of more than $300 million. It will allow us to upgrade science teaching and research and integrate the School of Psychology and the School of Environment into the main science precinct. This will in turn free up the Human Sciences Building for refurbishment as the centre of the arts faculty. Constant innovation is the cornerstone of a university such as ours. Innovative teaching and research is vital for long-term, sustainable economic growth of our country and social cohesion of our nation. This has never been more so than in the testing times we face in the wake of the global recession, the Christchurch earthquakes, and the yet-to-be-defined effects of global warming. Universities equip graduates like you not simply for the jobs of today, but for future careers not yet imagined in an ever-changing world. So as you graduate today, please reflect on the ongoing learning opportunities and consider the wide range of postgraduate options available to you at this university. Reflect on the changes in technology you have already experienced in your lifetime, and remember that most of the technology you will use in your future working career has yet to be developed or commercialised. I ask you to do this because we can never rest on our laurels, especially in a challenging and ever-changing world. Whatever path you follow as you go out into the world, I urge you, as the alumni of New Zealand's leading university, to never forget your alma mater, your university. We rely on our graduates for support, moral, political and financial. Funding constraints are a perennial problem for New Zealand universities, who are being asked to do more and more each year with less and less. In fact, we should be spending more on universities, not less. But don't worry, we will be in touch with you, and when we do, please lend us your support. But that is enough of the substantial issues facing us all as members of a 21st century university with high aspirations. Because today is your day. The focus is firmly on your achievement. And at this ceremony, we honour your success, along with the support of your family, whānau, and others who have sustained you through your studies. I congratulate you and trust that you'll long cherish the memories of your graduation today. I am pleased to introduce this afternoon's guest speaker, Catherine Corrich, who is the very talented founder and chair of the SysDoc Group, a high-tech services company with operations in four countries. Catherine leads global strategy and development of new markets. She's also currently launching a cloud-based technology company to offer business transformation products to the global marketplace. Under her stewardship, SysDoc has grown into a global business, delivering business change programs for major international corporations and offering advice and expertise to many public sector organisations in New Zealand, Australia, and the United Kingdom. Catherine also shares her time and expertise with a number of organisations dedicated to the advancement and welfare of women, at-risk children, and disadvantaged families around the world. Her leadership of performance-based philanthropy, including a current project designed to increase child protection and reduce child abuse, is groundbreaking. She's a regular guest lecturer at the University of Oxford's SED Business School Advanced Management Leadership Program, and she won Aveeno Businesswoman of the Year and was a finalist in the UK National Business Awards and has twice been awarded the Ernst & Young Entrepreneur of the Year Award. Her company has also won major awards for innovation, best practice, and knowledge management, and was named in the top four most innovative consulting companies in the United Kingdom MCA Awards. Catherine, we look forward to your address.
Chancellor, Vice-Chancellor, members of Council, members of University, graduates, family and friends. Today is a time of celebration for you all. Graduates, you started a journey that culminates today in considerable personal achievement. It's been hard work for many of you and your achievements are here on show today. Congratulations to each and every one of you. Standing in your shoes, I recall many years ago receiving my first degree and then my second degree, and each time realising that it was the beginning of a new journey. I had lots of nerves, lots of excitement. What would the future hold? Let me reassure you that in completing your degree, you've planted the seeds of a wonderful future. Excellent education offered by the University of Auckland will help you transform seeds of knowledge into kauri trees of experience. New Zealand ranked number one this year in the 2014 Social Progress Index. It ranked New Zealand on basic human needs, foundation of well-being and opportunity. That's a great global achievement for our country. Building on these foundations, imagine what our nation could achieve if we design businesses with social change outcomes. Outcomes that are good for citizens, good for our families, good for communities, and good for the planet, finally also feeding the souls of our staff. We have the potential to do this, and all of you graduating here today hold the key to our new future. Whether you choose to lead the team or be part of the team is not what's important. It's that you play in that team and you're prepared to make positive change. We live in a world that's in desperate need of role models, disruptive business models, and positive leadership. Leaders who inspire and connect people to make changes and deliver sustainable change. Businesses that our children and their children would want to work for because they protect our environment and they strengthen communities. Your contribution is just beginning. You have the power in your hands from today onwards to make the difference. But my advice to you is draw deeply on your own personal values. Think about what has made you, your your upbringing, your parents, your friends, your families, and build on those personal stories that have given you strength, because it is these personal stories, the small moments in your life, that will help you to really define who you become as a business leader or as a social leader as you choose. Doing this will unlock your true potential. I want to share with you just three moments in my life, and they literally are all moments, but they've helped to define who my company Sysdoc is today. It's helped define the DNA that's enabled us to globalise and transform large corporations around the world. At the moment in Britain, we're leading the largest business change program in the automotive industry. We're working with an organisation that has helped take Britain out of recession. And the key thing for me is that our values are drawn from the small moments. So we grew 80% last year in the UK in a time when in recession people would say that's not possible. We did it because we have five tenets of operation: honesty, courage, conviction, partnerships, and skill. So let me take you through just a couple of these. Honesty. Operate always with integrity, because it will pay dividends, big dividends in business. As a child, my family lived in Western Samoa. We were sent there as my father was chief pilot, lent by the New Zealand government as chief pilot to Polynesian Airlines. When we arrived, our suitcases didn't arrive, and we had 6 weeks of wearing just swimming costumes. After 6 weeks, my father said, well, this is a bit ridiculous. We should probably claim insurance. Our suitcases aren't arriving. Sometime later, some months later, our suitcases did arrive with stickers that they had been via Bolivia and Mexico. The very first thing that my father did is he said to the children, right, we need to make a trip to the insurance company. And we said, now why is that? And he said, because our suitcases arrived, therefore the money that we claimed is not rightfully ours. And he returned it. Now that for children is a defining moment. The second is courage. If you believe in something, regardless of what other people are telling you, if you believe in it, have the courage to actually take the risk and deliver on what you believe. Sysdoc's first major contract in the United Kingdom was 15 years ago, and overnight we had to onboard a very large team for a telco, telecommunications business change program. Within a couple of months, our monthly payroll was $1 million. $1 million for a small New Zealand company is a big risk. It's quite scary, and you have a huge responsibility to your staff. But we decided to self-fund from our New Zealand business. We decided to self-fund because we knew that if we did that, we would always deliver results. We could not afford to bring down our New Zealand business. So we did that as a young New Zealand company. We took a risk. So the principle on which we now build our business is that we're debt-free, with the ability to fund global expansion, because we have only ourselves to account to. The final example I want to share with you is one of conviction. Life is not a rehearsal. Believe in what you do and have fun doing it. In 1991, my father died very suddenly following a misdiagnosis in a hospital. It rocked our world. My mother and father, brothers and sisters, couldn't see a way forward. Our first reaction was anger and a desire for retribution. But a few wise words from our mother absolutely catalysed our lifelong response. Our mother said, don't waste your life in anger and bitterness. Your father had a good life, and his greatest joy would be for you to make a difference. Live a life that he would want you to live every day, and make positive changes every day so that no one else experiences what we've been through. How can you turn such positive anger and turn such anger into positive action? Examining what failed in my father's case, I vowed and decided to devote much of my activity in Sysdoc to optimise operational processes in healthcare and other industries. If we could save one person, then it would all be worth it. We know that we've done that in work in the oil industry in Kazakhstan, banking in Asia, and automotive in Britain. So my message to you is, take life's little moments, take life's hardships, and Draw from within yourself to transform those little hardships into the principles by which you lead your life going forward. Two final that I mentioned were skill and partnerships. Keep learning every day of your life. So it's probably the most vital piece of advice that I can share with you. My staff, my leadership team and myself are constantly putting ourselves through learning and development programs because we believe that we need to change and move with the times. And partnerships. Think very carefully about who you want to work with and who you share your life with, because a life of shared values, whether it's the people you choose to work with or whether it's your life partner, will make all the difference to how you can live your life and achieve your potential. So as you graduate today, build on the great education that you've received. We extend thanks to your professors, tutors, mentors, family and supporters who are celebrating your success. Your place in the world. If you're a New Zealander, go forth from today's celebration and showcase Kiwi talent and education to the world. If you came to study in New Zealand from another country, thank you for the gift that you've given us of sharing your culture and your country with us. May our connections be strong and enduring. And in the words of Nelson Mandela, there is no passion to be found in playing small, in settling for a life that is less than the one you are capable of living. Go forth and make positive change happen, and congratulations to every one of you.
Thank you, Catherine, for a challenging and most insightful speech. This is a meeting of Council and Convocation of the University at which the Pro-Chancellor, Peter Kiley, and I will be conferring degrees and awarding diplomas. I invite the Pro-Chancellor to award the diplomas and confer the degrees in the first half of this ceremony.
By the authority vested in me by resolution of the University of Auckland Council, I, Peter Kiley, Pro-Chancellor, award the diplomas and confer the degrees stated upon those who, within the Faculty of Business and Economics, have satisfied the requirements of this university.
I call upon an Associate Dean of the Faculty of Business and Economics, Mrs. Lawrenson, to present graduands in that faculty.
Pro-Chancellor, as Associate Dean, I have the honour of presenting to you the students qualified for the award of a diploma or conferment of a degree in the Faculty of Business and Economics. Graduate Diploma in Commerce. Mohammed Alfan Bush. Andy Faw. Thomas Cox. Rodney Britt Gerald Rodriguez. Justin Peter Turnock. Brandon Allen Twigley. Yuting Wang. To the degree of Bachelor of Commerce, Bin Yu Lee. Shemaine Ka Yu Lee. Hui Lee. Jenny Lee. Jiat Lee. Li Ran. Rinji Lee. Shui Li. Shujuan Li. Xiang Li. Junhui Li. Chen Liang. James Lin. Julian Lim. Jutata Lim Truckle. Junjin Lin. Mike Hin Shwing Lin. Xing Fin Lin. Jin Xiang Lin. Laura June Little. Fu Yang Liu. Ming Shi Liu. Ri Lu. Xu Tin Stephanie Liu. James William Lockie and a graduate diploma in commerce. Vishal Pratik Lodia. Simon Zoe Lopez Pereira. Senior Scholar, Business and Economics, Kate Elizabeth Lowen. Ji Yi Liu. Xiaoxi Liu. Vanessa Y. Kit Lum. Clifton Rowichi Lunt. Ying Liu. Louise Fern McNaughton. Matthew James McQueen. Emilio Maharaj. Muhammad Falil Satwika Mahmud. Matil Makanji. Stephen David Mail. Syed Manilal. Nathan Marinko. Harrison Louis Marquet. Donna Rose Martin. Andreo Putra Mazuki. Sophie Elizabeth Mason. Hamish Maud. Bradley Daniel Maxwell. James Michael McCormick. Braden Gregory McCulloch. Carmen Giselle McDougall. Oliver Andrew McDowell. Andrew John McComb. Ryan Scott McInnes. Emma Courtney McKenzie. Campbell Ian McMillan. Zane Sean McRae. Ruyun Meng. Emma Brooke Mercer. Oliver Gregory Meyer Smith. John Drake Min. Jivan Charles Miranda. Mahul Mystery. Mo Zhejin. Senior Scholar, Business and Economics, Isabel Jean Monk. Duane Ignatius Montero. Hans Christian Montalalu. Rose Alwyn Morris. Nicole Louise Morrison. Adam James Moss. Clinton Motupali. Amanda Pratana Moy. Jasmine Muller. Daniel John Murphy. Vignesh Rajesh Murthy. Devaran Shriva Nadu. Jaywant Ramesh Nana. Amit Atalesh Narayan. Shika Narayan. Juan Rafael Nebres Nepomukeno. Matthew Kerrod Newman. Max Peter Newton. Eugenia Chuan Erkung. Ung Kai Lap. Peijin Penny Ng. Victor Chi Wei Nai. An Tien Nguyen. Mi Hang Nguyen. Zhao Yu Ni. Bridget Claire O'Donnell. Fei Swan Jing Ong. Adam James Osborne. Brendan Tama McDesmond O'Sullivan Winther. U Zhongji. Shamata Puva Uza. Ravina Pai. Matthew Mark Woolley Palmer. Carmen Joy Wen Yi Pang. Jun Young Park. Anjanika Nalini Patel. Avinash Bharat Patel. Kapisha Ben Ashkopi Patel. Mittal Patel. Sharina Patel. Sunita Rina Patel. Samantha Louise Patterson Horse. Tessa Ann Pemberton. Ping E. An. Pierre Jeremy Roland Perez. Matthew John Pettit. Steve Phillip. Courtney Anastasia Beatrice Piazzon. Pauline Melioni Pickering. Charlotte Naomi Pagia. Marta Malgozata Plinza. Mark Sugijevich Plusinov. Vianti Polaya. Hamish Roderick Paulson. William Llewellyn Paul. Navneet Noel Prasad. Sunia Leroy Puluiku. Wujin Chi. Yan Wen Chiang. Kaylin Chu. Eugene Quick. Penelope Mary Quirk. Baron Thomas Manners Redburn. Heo Raiz Rosaini. Nikita Renu Ram. Katrina Helen Rasmussen. Mansi Nitikumar Nathod. Meenakshi Devi Vidi. Luren. Derek Peter Rennie. Michael Paul Rippon. Fraser William Roche. Rebecca Roygaard. Jamie Lee Rowlands. Gladys Cecilia Roundtree. Lachlan James Russell. Margie Rani Sari. Ayesha Sachdeva. Nazhat Saleem. Mayim Taufik Salah. Andrew William Sargent. Surat Sawadi Satsanapiti. Gaurav Dinesh Satya. Kruger ko ma'afu shanko. Stephanie Ntuya Sebastian Johendrian. Shivanita Devi Up Selvaraj. Chuan Yin Seo. Yuzhia Xiao. Yuzhia Xiao. Avishu Meshama. Ekta Sharma. Jessica Lee Shaw. Leon Going Shen. Yuqing Shi. Lacey. Jan Ling Xu. Minchul Sim. Oliver Thomas Simon. Gurpal Singh. Hakaran Singh. Joshua Singh. Karandeep Singh. Manpreet Singh. Salvendra Karanesh Singh. John Paul Smith. Glenn Thomas Smith. Kathy Irene Smith. Matthew Peter Smitherham. Zet Weisner. Audrey Leonita Maria Soegiato. Jamie Ong Song. Ha Rim Song. Haiwan Song. Kyung Jae Song. Swayam Sanjay Soni. Kira Sonari Sukru. Tanaz Kelly Snorty. Senior Scholar, Business and Economics, Belinda Jane Spreu-Wenberg. Avishka Srivasatha. Monique Stander. Blair Patrick Stevenson. Jessica Emma Stewart. Laura Ann Stitchbury. James Peter Stolton. Zhui Jian Su. Deepika Selek. Yajuan Sun. Lance Robert Talbot. Nigel Keane Hoctan. Ji Jong Tan. Jing Ji Tang. Lei Tong. Miriam Torfik. Michael Wei Kiat Te. Matthew Andrew Taylor. Zi Chi Ting. Sagan Shukuma Tamala. Jaya Tapa. Nicholas Joseph Thomas. Qian Simiao. Stephanie Chu. Shona Chi Ying Tiong. Melanie Tima Tikach. Rob Shi Tiong. Wing Fai Tong. Mobilia Topa. Katie Ann Louisa Topping. Jordan James Tran. Francis Maria Tribuhovic. Georgian Timothy Vitali Swift Tuala. Flamel Michelle Turner. Uesiliani Male Legin Ualasi Tuolata Malela Unasa. Justin John Joel Young Yi.
Thank you, Pro-Chancellor, for conferring the degrees and awarding the diplomas in the first half of this ceremony. One of the great pleasures of graduation is the opportunity to hear performances by students from our acclaimed School of Music. Sylvia Jiang on piano will now form Transcendental Etude No. 10 by Liszt. Thank you. Thank you, Sylvia, for that amazing piece of work. Can you all join with me in thanking Sylvia once again? By the authority vested in me by resolution of the University of Auckland Council, I, Ian Parton, Chancellor, award the diplomas and confer the degrees stated upon those who, within the Faculty of Business and Economics, have satisfied the requirements of this university. I call upon the Dean of the Faculty of Business and Economics, Professor Greg Whitchard, to present further graduands in that faculty.
To the degree of Bachelor of Commerce, Win Yi Fong. Miguel Paolo Valero. Alexina Trina Van Ness. Suzanne Van Sittert. Prasanth Vasanath. Amelia Mary Vila. Timothy Ruda Ventura. Lisa Corinne Verity. Samuel James Vesey. Benjamin Anthony Vaiti. Galavale Vila. Jurameth Vorachatan. Meliami Vulangi. Fei Wong. Fei Fei Wong. Ke Jia Wong. Mo Wong. Ching Wong. Shi Jia Wong. Shin Ran Wong. Shu Wong. Ye Yun Wong. Yue Wong. Zhao Wong. Lei Yuan Wei. Christy Ann Welsh. Wu Suk Wee. George Frederick Ioannis Wilkes. Saskia Kirsten Willett. Rafe Simeon Williams. Ross Penryn Williams. Georgia Rose Wilton. Ernest Wenhao Wong. Fei Young Wong. Lisa Leontine Wong. Ryan Davis Waiyan Wong. Wong Tak Wai. Tiffany Wong. Ji Young Woo. Chi Wa Woo. Wan Ting Woo. Yi Ning Woo. Li Jun Chu. Xu Yan. Xu Yao. Dong Yang. Jin Yao. Ka Wai Yap. Yap Jun Liang Sean. Mei Ling Yao. Dylan Can Yildiz. Yun Xiang Yin. Michael Yu. Nigel Sing Yun Yu. Yu Chi Fai. Zhou Chang Yu. Wenxi Yuan. Chuk Nam Yun. Ho Bung Yun. Jan Fei Zheng. Harvey Zhang. Hong Mei Zhang. Jiang Ning. Chu Yan Zhang. Feng Zizhong. Jin Yu Zhong. Zhou Ru. Yu Jing Zhou. Ningbo Zhu. Peng Zhu. Xiao Jing Zhou. To the degree of Bachelor of Property, Blair Stewart Botherway. Samantha Meredith Bilt and a Bachelor of Commerce. Dylan Neville Carmichael. James William Cole. Timothy Shea Doherty. Jared Glynn Felton. Logan Simkin Holyoke. Rajiv Kumar Joshi. Song Lee. Sophia Mao. Hilary Christine McNaughton. Katrin Ellen Pask. Benjamin William Phipps. Jack Theodore Revel. Monju Saka. Graham Roche Shearer. Connor Patrick Joseph Taylor. Justin Ting Hua Hien. Peng Peng Hui Yin. To the degree of Bachelor of Commerce Conjoint, Charles Ma, and a Bachelor of Engineering Honours with Second Class Honours, First Division in Civil Engineering. Alicia Kate McKinley, and a Bachelor of Property. Lucas Connor McWilliam, and a Bachelor of Property. John Bertram Midgley, Bachelor of Property. Jan Barry Miller, and a Bachelor of Arts. Sum Yeo Florence Ng, and a Bachelor of Arts. Amy Frances Osborne, and a Bachelor of Arts. Harshal Narendra Patel, and a Bachelor of Arts. Lucas Predrira, and a Bachelor of Arts. Stephanie Monique Perrin, and a Bachelor of Science. Gunjan Vijay Punjabi, and a Bachelor of Science. Vincent Paul Q, and a Bachelor of Arts. Monique Joy Richardson, and a Bachelor of Arts. Annabelle Lisa Dulu Robertson, and a Bachelor of Arts. Nuhad Hiba Saad, and a Bachelor of Arts. Natalie Julia Saunders, and a Bachelor of Arts. Teresa Virginia Scandrett, and a Bachelor of Arts. William Kwok Sydenham, and a Bachelor of Arts. Kirsty Elizabeth Simpson, and a Bachelor of Arts. Anton Carl Albert Smith, and a Bachelor of Laws. Natalie Jane Smith, and a Bachelor of Arts. Senior Scholar, Business and Economics, Yu Kai So, and a Bachelor of Science. Danielle Jane Stephanie, and a Bachelor of Arts. Joseph Alexander Sweeney, and a Bachelor of Arts. Sarah Jamie Lee Tacken, and a Bachelor of Arts. Tara Louisa Toman, and a Bachelor of Arts. James Tsai, and a Bachelor of Arts. Paramita Turner, and a Bachelor of Arts. Senior Scholar, Business and Economics, Sanjeet Uttam, and a Bachelor of Science. Kathleen Nicole Palmiano Verano, and a Bachelor of Arts. Senior Scholar, Business and Economics, Kirsty Leah Vervoet, and a Bachelor of Property. Wei Ji Wang, and a Bachelor of Property. Stephanie Claire Waterman, and a Bachelor of Arts. Christine Nicole Wilson, and a Bachelor of Arts. Jack Shu, and a Bachelor of Arts. Minyue Shu, and a Bachelor of Science. Teresa Gan Ming Yi, and a Bachelor of Arts. Roderick Hong Shen Yen, and a Bachelor of Science. An Chi Yin, and a Bachelor of Arts. Tang Zhui Yin, and a Bachelor of Arts. Simon Kai Sun Yun, and a Bachelor of Arts. Ni Zeng, and a Bachelor of Arts. Bachelor of Property, Conjoint. Holly Ray Ash, and a Bachelor of Commerce. Milasini Banyayan Brickell, and a Bachelor of Commerce. Andrew Ferguson Brown, and a Bachelor of Commerce. Shannon Marie Douglas Dunn, and a Bachelor of Commerce. Tian Yi Du, and a Bachelor of Commerce. Daniel Fruin, and a Bachelor of Commerce. Ryan William Larson, and a Bachelor of Commerce. Yun Lee, and a Bachelor of Commerce. Daniel Bain Millmine, and a Bachelor of Commerce. Rahul Anil Patel, and a Bachelor of Commerce. Meera Arvind Seema, and a Bachelor of Commerce. Samantha Rose Stretton, and a Bachelor of Commerce. Kelly Kaining Wong, and a Bachelor of Commerce. Postgraduate Diploma in Property with Merit. Hui Young. To the degree of Bachelor of Commerce Honours with First Class Honours. Postgraduate Diploma in Property with Merit, Hui Young. To the degree of Bachelor of Commerce Honours with First Class Honours, Vinay Mahant in Commercial Law. Shobia Mughal in Marketing. Lisa Roseanne Pook in Management. David William Quigg in Accounting and a Bachelor of Commerce. Christian William Innes Rind in Economics and a Bachelor of Commerce. Rebecca Amy Richards in Accounting and a Bachelor of Commerce. Joshua Benjamin Tan in Finance. Tanjian Xiang in Accounting. Finn Matthew Templeton in Finance. Sylvie Marjorie Thrush Marsh in Management. University Graduate Scholar Andrew James Tort in Economics. Alexander Benjamin Chi Siong Won in Finance. Senior Scholar, Business and Economics, Nicholas Stewart Wilkes in Accounting and a Bachelor of Commerce. Philippa Jane Wright in Marketing. To the degree of Bachelor of Commerce Honours with Second Class Honours First Division, Bhavisha Ben Maheshbhai Patel in Marketing. Lekamagi Uvina Manthila Pereira in Economics. Priya Shurez Prakesh in Marketing. Caitlin Tan in Commercial Law and a Bachelor of Commerce. Mikla Nadine Thebeau in Commercial Law and a Bachelor of Commerce. Karen Ng in Management. Thomas James Wills in Finance and a Bachelor of Commerce. To the degree of Bachelor of Commerce Honours with Second Class Honours Second Division, Alexander Glenn Watson in Commercial Law and a Bachelor of Commerce. Cheng Xu in Economics. Arcadius Zaiwat in International Business. To the degree of Bachelor of Property Honours with First Class Honours, Vincent Shi Yang Feng. To the degree of Bachelor of Property Honours with Second Class Honours First Division, Ko Yul Bajpai. Adam David Curtis. To the degree of Master of Commerce with First Class Honours, Amy Emiko Aolani Bonham in Management. Emma May Fitzgerald in Marketing. University Graduate Scholar Yi Ting Huang in Economics. Meng Long Huo in Management. Elena Jane Jacobs in International Business. Amrita Lal, Marketing. Jessica Yeon Lee in Marketing. Tian Wern Leong in Economics and a Postgraduate Diploma in Commerce in Economics and a Bachelor of Commerce. Yang Liu, International Business. Elena Andreevna Obushenkova in Management. Sarah Elizabeth Pigou in Management. To the degree of Master of Commerce with Second Class Honours First Division, Subhita Chattavardi in Management. Nan Lee in Finance. Su Ji Lee in Finance. To the degree of Master of International Business with First Class Honours, Manas Nanda. Kesiniya Andreevna Nichayeva. Miriam Seifert. Caitlin Ann Tatum. To the degree of Master of International Business with Second Class Honours, First Division, Daniela Bosch. Rahul Chopra. Shin Tong Gong. Chi Mai Huang. Yu Min Lee. Fahad Nahal. Diana Ramirez Gonzalez. Natalie Amanda Roy. Dominic Schmitz. Yui Ming Kim. To the degree of Master of International Business with Second Class Honours, Second Division, Yu Ling Cheng. Liu Yun Chu. Shi Wen Jiao. Vanak Kit. Fu Mai Nguyen. Yin Xing Piao. Yu Yi Chuan.
I now call upon the Vice-Chancellor to present the doctoral graduands.
Chancellor, I have the honour of presenting to you the doctoral graduands. To the degree of Doctor of Philosophy, Sam Malafay in Economics. Sam analysed and investigated current New Zealand policy related to the development of geothermal resources. He identified areas of improvement and suggested economic policies that contribute towards reducing depletion rates while allowing electricity generators to operate at a profitable level. Sam. Brad James Austin McKenna in Information Systems, University Doctoral Scholar. Brad investigated how people use virtual worlds to lobby for social and political change through collective action. His research explored the differences between physical world and virtual world social movements and how technological evolutions impact the way in which they are organised. Parizad Muller in Management and Employment Relations, University Doctoral Scholar. Parizad explored Generation Y's use of social networking sites and impression management strategies in work context, a phenomenon that is essentially new and evolving in the social world. Her pioneering research explored the developing implications of social media use for individuals and organisations from socio-psychological and demographic perspectives. Parizad. Frederick Chang Yu Ning, an Accounting University Doctoral Scholar. Fred created a taxonomy to classify patterns of decision-making by firms in relation to their revenue management behaviour and validated this using a comprehensive survey of New Zealand firms. This classification system enables best practice to be identified, as well as offering tools for businesses to assess and improve their own revenue management practices. Manuel José III de los Reyes Oyson in Management. Manuel studied the internationalisation of small New Zealand firms and the role of the entrepreneur and entrepreneurial thinking in internationalisation. His research provides an entrepreneurial perspective on how such firms discover, create and exploit opportunities in international markets. Manuel. Max Eric Rode in Information Systems, University Doctoral Scholar. Max designed, implemented, and evaluated a software platform which allows the development of applications in a more knowledge-friendly manner. Max. Yang-Yan Shi in Operations and Supply Chain Management. Yang-Yan investigated third-party purchase as a value-added service offered by third-party logistics providers based on transaction cost theory. The primary contribution from this research is to help third-party logistics providers gain sustained competitive advantages through offering third-party purchase services. Yang-Yan. Shapur Vodanovich in Information Systems. Shapur's thesis sought to understand and explore the impact of ubiquitous spaces such as social networking technologies on the well-being and development of young people. Shapur. And in absentia, all those other persons named in the official record qualified for the conferment of a degree or the award of a diploma in the Faculty of Business and Economics.
Teaching Excellence Awards. The university places considerable significance on excellence in teaching. It recognises this by making awards each year to teachers who have demonstrated excellence in aspects of teaching. These awards are contestable across the university and signify a truly superior achievement. An award for excellence in early career excellence in teaching has been made to Mr. Rob Batty in the Department of Commercial Law within the Faculty of Business and Economics. I call upon a student of that faculty, Jim Thompson, to read the citation for Mr. Batty.
Everyone who takes commercial law knows Rob. Mention his name to a student who took part of his intellectual property class or was involved with the honours course, and you will receive a warm response. They will describe him as friendly, approachable, interesting, caring, but most of all they say he was interested. Rob cares about his students. He wants them to perform well, not just because it's his job, but because he wants the students to get the most from their education. One of the criteria for this award was that Rob's teaching was student-centred, inclusive, and promoting of engaged and effective learning. It takes special effort and a genuine desire to be a good teacher in order to meet these criteria. To me, that describes Rob's teaching very accurately. Law is a dense subject, and for most business students, the intricacies of the law are not of great interest. They aren't going to go on and sit the bar exam or be lawyers, and Rob recognised this. He engaged students by making the content relevant to their interests. His courses focus on what an accountant, business advisor, business owner, or analyst needs to know about commercial law. Rob would set assignments with broad guidelines that tackled real-life problems. They weren't always popular, but they required students to think critically and identify potential legal issues you face in a business world. This is exactly the ability that students need as they go out into their careers, and Rob understood this. Under his guidance, students are being very well prepared for the careers they head into. As a postgraduate supervisor, Rob was understanding of how students worked through their assignments. His supportive nature was appreciated by all of the honours students, who were inevitably faced with challenges during their research. As a teacher, Rob did far more than merely pass on knowledge, and this is the key to his success. To receive this award so early in his career is exceptional, and a credit to Rob's talent and commitment as a teacher.
We are nearing the conclusion of the formal part of the ceremony. On behalf of the university, I invite all today's graduates to stand and receive the congratulations of us all. And while you are standing, it would be a good time for the graduates to show their appreciation of their families and supporters and staff of the university who have helped them as they achieve their qualifications. This concludes this meeting of council and convocation of the university for the conferment of degrees and the award of diplomas. I now invite you all to stand and sing the first verse of God Defend New Zealand in Māori, then in English. The words are printed on the reverse of your programme.
2 million.